Today, I'm going to share with you one trick that everyone seems to miss when it comes to how to get better results with ChatGPT. So let's get into it. So when it comes to using ChatGPT, the biggest mistake that most people make is that they just start a brand new prompt on ChatGPT, take whatever it gives them, and then they roll with it. That is not the best way to use ChatGPT. Instead of doing that, ChatGPT actually has this awesome ability to remember things and actually learn things. And the way that you can help ChatGPT to do this is by feeding it. So I'm going to show you how I personally feed ChatGPT to help me with things like emails and even writing content and outlines. So let me show this to you. This hack is going to change the way that you use ChatGPT moving forward. All right, so first of all, it depends on whether or not you're using the free version of ChatGPT or the paid. It really doesn't matter. The free version works with this, but they've actually added a new feature that I want to go over just really quickly. If you click your account at the top right, there's a customized ChatGPT option. And if you click this, you can actually feed ChatGPT some information right now about who you are. So this will actually help when you make brand new prompts without having to feed it every time. This section is asking things like what your occupation is, what sort of hobbies do you have, what are some goals that you have, and then there's also a section for how you would like ChatGPT to respond. It's asking things like how long or short do you want responses to be on average, how do you want to be addressed, like what are your pronouns. Should ChatGPT have opinions on topics rather than remain neutral? So you can give it some information here so that when you give it just brand new blank prompts, it's going to have a little bit of you in there. But I'm actually going to show you an even more in-depth way to feed ChatGPT to give it more information to actually write like you, talk like you, and I'm going to go into that right now. So if you're using the free version of ChatGPT, it isn't connected to the live internet, so you cannot give it a URL to ask it to learn about that URL, but what you can do is you can feed it with information. So if you're using the free version of ChatGPT, this is how you would feed it information to be able to learn and then give you a new answer based on the information that it's learned. Why would you want to do this? Well, as you know, with ChatGPT 3.5, the free version of ChatGPT, it is limited with its knowledge. I think it's back to 2021 or something like that, but it's not real-time current. Now, if you have ChatGPT 4.0, it's still using an older language model, but you can actually ask it to go and fetch something online or look at a URL and learn something. So this is really important. This is how you can get better results with ChatGPT is by feeding it information or giving it a data set and then letting it work from that data set that it gave you. So for example, if you had some very technical information that you need to make sure stays accurate in the answer or the thing that ChatGPT is coming out with, you can actually feed it that data set. So I'm going to show this to you right now. So for example, if I wanted to write a piece on the income that Google made in 2023, I could go to Google and I could search for Google income for 2023. So of course, as a human, I would want to go through these different sources and find and look at the right source that I feel is the most credible. So I'm going to pick this one from Yahoo because it's in more of a blog type format instead of charts and things like that. Not to say that ChatGPT can't understand charts, but I'm going to make it a little bit easy on ChatGPT here. So I'm going to click on this piece of content where it goes over the earnings that Google made, and all I'm going to do is literally copy and paste all the text from this article. Make sure that I don't grab a different piece of content here. I'm going to copy that. So inside of ChatGPT, I'm going to ask it to learn this information. So I can say learn this information, colon, paste that in, and hit enter. So now ChatGPT is going to take this information and it's going to learn it. So at the bottom, it's actually giving me a summary and it's telling me that its memory has been updated. So it now knows this information. So now that I have given ChatGPT a locked data set, I can ask it to write me new content just using the information from this data set, which means it is not going to go to its bigger language model and come up with its own hallucinations or things like that. That's not to say that it still won't hallucinate, but this is going to give you just a much better version of content from the get-go instead of having to go in and manipulate and massage it over and over and over again to get the correct facts. So if I wanted to use this data set and have ChatGPT write me something new, I could say, write me a 400-word blog post summarizing the information you learned. And it's going to do that. So it's going to take the data set that I just gave it, and it's now going to stay within the parameters of that data set to write me new content. So now you can see I've got a great piece of starting content with accurate numbers from the data set that I gave it. Now that was just feeding ChatGPT one piece of content, but I could feed ChatGPT multiple pieces of content and have it write a new piece, taking all the summaries that it just learned. And I'm going to show that to you now. So I'm just going to go ahead and start a new chat up at the top. And we're going to start with a new piece of content, but we want to feed it, let's say, three pieces of content. So now what we're going to do is we're going to get on Google and find three pieces of content that are related about the same subject. We're going to feed all three of those to ChatGPT so that it can then take all of that information and now create a new piece based off of those three different sources. So again, we're going to go to Google, and I'm just going to do something a little bit more fun here, like how to wash your dog. So I'm going to just type in how to wash your dog. And we're going to get a couple of pieces of content here. So we're going to get one from this one, how to give a dog a bath. And we are going to take this content, and I'm just going to grab it. I'm going to copy it with Control C, or if you're on a Mac, it would be Command C. I'm going to grab this content, I'm going to copy it, and I'm going to paste it into ChatGPT. I'm going to say, learn this information, colon, paste it in, and hit enter. And while it's learning that, I'm going to go back to Google, and I'm going to feed it another piece. So I'm going to find another one about how to bathe a dog. Go in here, I'm going to take this content, and I'm going to copy that. I'm going to feed that to ChatGPT. So I'm going to say, also, learn this information, and paste that in. And you can see here that I could do this with, you know, the next one as well. But this just gives you the idea. Instead of three, we'll just do two here. But ChatGPT is learning this information. So now I can prompt ChatGPT to say, use all the information that you've learned to write me a new piece about how to bathe a dog. So we're going to do that right now. Okay, so we're going to prompt. We're going to say, using all of the information that you've learned, write me a new 500-word blog post about how to bathe your dog. So you can see here now that ChatGPT is working with those two blog posts that I fed it to come up with a generative version using the information or the data that was inside of that data set that I gave it to write something that is pretty great. Now again, I would not take this and copy and paste it and put it in a blog post. Google has penalized straight up AI content. You would not want to do that. You're not going to get results doing it. But could I take this content, change it, humanize it, maybe even write my own version of it using this outline? Absolutely. This would be a great way to save me time and speed me up. So I've just shown you how you would use the free version of ChatGPT by actually copying and pasting in the information to teach it that information. But if you have ChatGPT 4 and you're paying for the pro version, it is connected to the internet. So I could actually save myself a little bit of time here by just telling it to learn the information at a URL. So for example, if we start a brand new chat, I could take the URL from the content that I had fed it earlier, and I can go into ChatGPT and say, learn the information at this URL. And I could just paste the URL in there, and it would learn the same information that I just fed it the other way by copying and pasting the actual text on the page. So I could then feed it another URL, and then I could ask it to create a new piece of content using all the information that it had learned. So ChatGPT 4 does speed you up a little bit because it can crawl a URL and it can learn the information at a URL. So I've just shown you how you can use ChatGPT by feeding it statistics, data, information, and then have ChatGPT work within that information to create content for you. Now there's also another way to feed ChatGPT to help speed you up to make sure that the writing that it makes sounds more like you. And the way that you would do that is you would feed ChatGPT things that you've written in the past to have it learn your writing style. So let me show you that. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how you would teach ChatGPT your writing style. Why would this be useful? Well, this is great because you can have ChatGPT help you writing emails, coming up with other sort of writing that comes from you. It just helps to speed you up a little bit to be able to sound more like you. So one of the best ways to teach ChatGPT your writing style is to take a couple of things that you've written. I wouldn't just do it off of one piece of content, but I would feed ChatGPT at least two pieces of content of something that you've written to help it learn your writing style. So we're going to do that exact same thing. So here I have two blog posts that I have written. I'm just going to go ahead and take the content from both of those, and I'm going to give it one big paste into ChatGPT. So I'm going to tell ChatGPT, learn the writing style from this text. And I'm going to put a colon. I'm going to paste in the first one. Then I'm going to go to the second blog post, which I've already got highlighted here to copy the text. I'm going to copy that. And I'm just going to do a return space, paste it in, and hit enter. So now ChatGPT is learning the writing style of this piece of content or the pieces of content that I gave it. And you can see here that the memory has been updated. So it's telling me how that writing style kind of works. So I could say to ChatGPT, you know, to remember this writing style as my writing style. So I can kind of give it a, you know, category label so that it can remember that in the future. So I could say, remember this writing style as Greg's writing style, and hit enter. So now ChatGPT has told me that it's noted that this writing style is referred to as Greg's writing style. So now from here on out, if I tell ChatGPT, even in a new chat, to write something for me using this writing style, it's going to remember this, which is actually pretty cool. So let's put this into practice. I've just created a new chat inside of ChatGPT. And remember, this other chat that we just created is where we taught it the writing style and we told it to remember it as Greg's writing style. So inside of a brand new chat, I could say, write an email using Greg's writing style that talks about how important it is to use keywords in your content. Make this email 200 words or less. So watch this. So it's going to actually write something using Greg's writing style, which is me. So it's using all of that information that I had fed it previously to now write an email that sounds more like me. So this is just a great way to be able to speed you up with writing emails to colleagues. Anything that you need to shoot off to somebody can just save you a little bit of time, and it's gonna sound more like you because it's learned your writing style. I hope that you can see the power of feeding ChatGPT information. By feeding ChatGPT information, you can have it work within the parameters of that data set that you've set for it, which can help you to get better results than just allowing it to run wild inside of its large language model. Feeding ChatGPT your writing style can also help you to speed things up, like writing emails, coming up with, you know, announcements to people inside of your company, or even responding to emails inside of your company. So I hope that you found some value in this video and that you'll be able to speed up some of your writing time when it comes to emails, blog posts, things like that, by feeding ChatGPT. If you like this video, make sure that you hit like and subscribe so that you'll be notified as we put out more helpful information like this. Thanks so much for joining us today, and we'll see you on the next video.